So hi, everybody. My name is Mark Dracos, and I'm going to talk to you today about cartilage repair in the ankle, comparison of functional and radiographic outcomes of Talar osteochondral lesions repaired with a mixture of particulate cartilage extracellular matrix and bone marrow aspirate concentrate versus microfracture. The background is that ankle injuries are one of the most common sports injuries. Ankle sprains are among the most common reasons people come into the emergency room. Osteochondral lesions of the talus in the setting of ankle injuries are also very common. Some studies suggest they can occur in up to 50% of severe ankle sprains and up to 78% of fractures. And if you look at the images below, you can see cartilage on the left, which has delaminated off of the subchondral bone, and then on the right, where essentially there is a bare area of subchondral bone, and due to the avascular nature of the articular cartilage, is not prone to healing. So what are our treatment options? Well, there are some studies that suggest there's almost a 45% failure rate when treated conservatively. And again, this is because the cartilage has a poor vascular supply and tends not to heal on its own. So that leaves us with operative strategies. These include a reparative strategy. The current standard of care is microfracture. The idea behind microfracture is you have a hole or a lesion, and then you put small perforations and you perforate the subchondral plate in order to get bleeding, and then some mesenchymal stem cells from the intermedullary contents of the bone will then bubble up to the surface and then fill in the defect. This fills with fibrocartilage, which has long-term concerns. There are some studies that suggest there's a 35% deterioration in 5 years. So our question was, can these outcomes be improved? We sought to seek out whether or not bone marrow concentrate could improve the tissue with which it heals. And when injecting bone marrow concentrate, we wanted to keep it over the area of the lesion. So the thought process was, if we could have some sort of matrix or substrate to hold it in place, that it might improve outcomes. So the substrate we chose was a micronized allogenic cartilage extracellular matrix. This is a relatively new option. Some good outcomes have been reported in series, but there's low clinical numbers and limited objective radiographic data and comparative analysis with controls. And this is an example of the actual substrate. So on the right, you can see mixing. And basically, we make a sandwich out of this where we put the bone marrow concentrate at the bottom of the tube, mix it with the extracellular matrix allograft, and then create basically a putty, which can then be injected or placed arthroscopically to more accurately cover the lesion. The components of this matrix include type 2 collagen, proteoglycans, cartilaginous growth factors, and the bone marrow concentrate has a small percentage of mesenchymal stem cells. But we do get adequate fill of the defect. And I believe that this matrix does act as a lattice to hold the bone marrow concentrate in the appropriate position. So this is a video of how we would do the procedure arthroscopically. And the first part of the procedure is you remove all the loose articular cartilage tissue with the combination of a curette and a shaver. And then you have to do a dry arthroscopy. And then once you do that, you can actually put in the substrate of the bone marrow concentrate with the matrix. And then this is us just contouring it into position. It's kind of like a glorified masonry, filling in potholes. But you can get a nice contour. You can even do it on shoulder lesions, and it can really adequately fill up the defect. So this picture just shows a before and after. You have a large hole, the subchondral plate has been violated, and this is after it's filled with the extracellular matrix and bone marrow concentrate combination. So the purpose of this study was to assess both clinical and radiographic outcomes following treatment of osteochondral lesions of the talus with a mixture of this micronized allogenic cartilage extracellular matrix as well as the bone marrow concentrate. And then we were going to compare these outcomes to microfracture, this current standard of care. For our study design, we had several inclusion criteria. We wanted a minimum of 1 year post-op. We basically had a clinical portion in which we had pre and post-op FAOS scores as well as PROMIS scores. And then for our radiographic follow-up, at least 6 months post-op, we got MRIs of the patients, and we did a MOCART scoring system, which evaluates the reparative cartilage for structural integrity. And then we did our statistical analysis to look for differences between the two groups. So here are two groups on the left. This was our microfracture group. We did break down the microfracture group into subgroups. So the microfracture group had 44 patients with microfracture alone, and then another 43 patients where microfracture was augmented with just injected bone marrow concentrate. So again, the reason for having the matrix is that we postulated that it could keep this in place, but we wanted to just inject it into the ankle as well to see if that played any role, or did the bone marrow concentrate just go into all over the ankle and not stay where we wanted it. On the right, you see our extracellular matrix bone marrow concentrate group, where we also had 81 patients. Average follow-up was almost 2 years. Our average lesion size was about 76 millimeters. The average age was the same, and these were ultimately statistically similar groups to start with. So both of the groups involved primarily smaller lesions. These are lesions smaller than about 150 millimeters squared, and most of these lesions were medial. So again, similar groups to start off with. We had 69 out of 87 microfracture patients with clinical follow-up, 61 out of 81 of the extracellular matrix bone marrow concentrate. We were able to have 48 patients with radiographic follow-up spread amongst the groups. These were the concomitant procedures. A lot of patients had concurrent ankle instability, but again, the ankle instability was in both groups, both the microfracture group and the ECM-BMC group. A couple of them had multiple OCLs, which were also addressed by the aforementioned methods. So these were our functional outcomes. This was for microfracture, which showed that, you know, even our microfracture patients did improve with microfracture from a clinical follow-up standpoint. Similarly, our ECM-BMC group did improve with, this is pre and post-op FAOS and PROMIS scores. They improved in almost all categories when this technique was used. So when we tried to compare the two groups, there was not a large statistical difference between the groups in terms of post-operative FAOS outcome scores between the microfracture and the ECM bone marrow concentrate group. And this went for many of the different subcategories as well. They both improved and both were actually pretty similar. And when we controlled for size, just to match up the sizes so that they were equal, they were also pretty similar as well. So there were no statistically significant differences. When looking at functional outcome scores between the two groups, again, there were similarities. There were some of the categories did improve with the ECM-BMAC group in terms of change compared to the other group, but there were none that were statistically significant. When looking at the comparative radiographic outcomes, there was a large difference between the two. So our ECM bone marrow concentrate group had an average MOCART score of 73, whereas both the microfracture alone and the microfracture with bone marrow concentrate were similar at about 55 to 58 in terms of their MOCART scores. This was statistically significant between both of those groups. So both, this is was true for the ECM bone marrow concentrate group versus the microfracture alone patients, as well as the microfracture and bone marrow concentrate patients. And there was no difference between microfracture alone and microfracture with just the injection of bone marrow concentrate. And these are just some slides looking at some of the differences between the two. Again, this was statistically significant. So this slide looks at the radiographic results and looks at the subcategories within the MOCART scoring system. And there were several statistically significant differences between the ECM bone marrow concentrate group and the microfracture group. Specifically, there was greater infill with the ECM bone marrow concentrate group. There was more incorporation, there was less fissures, and there was less edema. So structurally, the ECM bone marrow concentrate group appeared to have better quality tissue in terms of the reparative fill of the defect than the traditional microfracture. The most important finding we found in our study was with regards to revision surgery. So we found that the rate of revision surgery for microfracture was almost 28%, whereas the revision rate for the ECM bone marrow concentrate group was less than 5%. This was a statistically significant difference. And it was largely due, we feel, to the quality of the tissue that filled in the defect. If you look at the pictures on the right, 9 months after microfracture, the patient still had persistent edema. There were actually several patients in this group where the edema was worse from pre-op to post-op, which can happen with microfracture. And there, this persistent edema, we think, may have led to persistent symptoms, ultimately requiring revision surgery. So this was probably the biggest finding in our study, was that the revision surgery rate within 2 years after the index procedure was statistically higher in the microfracture group. And again, we feel that this was likely due to the performance of the ECM bone marrow concentrate group having less hypertrophy and limited postoperative edema compared to the other group. And this is a case with follow-up at about 2 years, where there's limited edema and the patient has good fill of the defect based on cartilage-sensitive sequences on MRI. And this is just a picture of, you know, after addressing the lesion with the ECM BMC, you were able to minimize some of this postoperative edema and hence improve some of our MOCART scores. So in conclusion, the structural quality of the reparative tissue may be better based on significant differences in MOCART scores. It may be better clinically based on revision surgery rates, and continued follow-up and long-term data are needed. But this was encouraging to show that when you added an extracellular matrix with bone marrow concentrate, it appears that the quality of the reparative tissue improved from your traditional microfracture. Thank you.